Hi, I'm Chris Wardlaw for CarGurus, and this is the 2017 Hyundai Santa Fe Sport. You can tell it's sporty by its 19-inch dark finish wheels. Well, that and the fact that it's both dimensionally smaller than and stylistically different from the standard Santa Fe. Sport models also seat no more than 5 people, while the Santa Fe holds up to 7 passengers. You can't get a V6 engine in a sport model either, like you can in a larger Santa Fe. Confused? Think of the Santa Fe Sport as similar to a Ford Edge, and the Santa Fe as the equivalent of a Ford Explorer. All right, now that we've got that all cleared up, let's go for a drive. My Santa Fe Sport test vehicle is decked out with nearly every option. It lacks only all-wheel drive and a handful of dealer-installed accessories, and the price is $39,410. Now that includes the $895 shipping charge that it's gonna take to get it from the factory in Georgia to your local dealership. Now you're not actually gonna pay that much for this SUV. As we're filming this review, you can get a $2,500 rebate on the Santa Fe Sport, or you can get 0.9% financing for 60 months and $1,750 in your pocket. Now that sounds pretty good, doesn't it? So the question is, do you actually want a Hyundai Santa Fe Sport? Hyundai makes good on the sport part of this SUV's name in more ways than just the styling. If you upgrade from the base model and its 185 horsepower, 2.4 liter four-cylinder engine, you're rewarded with a turbocharged 2-liter four-cylinder that makes an impressive 240 horsepower and 260 pound-feet of torque. A 6-speed automatic transmission powers the front wheels, and an intuitively mapped manual shift gate helps the driver to take command over gear selection. Now, even though a loaded Santa Fe Sport 2.0T Ultimate, like my test vehicle, weighs nearly 2 tons, the turbocharged engine provides plenty of power. Acceleration is brisk, the Santa Fe Sport effortlessly passes slower vehicles and climbs mountain grades, and I've got no complaints about the brakes either. Eco, normal, and sport driving modes will calibrate the drivetrain accordingly, as well as the electric steering. Now, maybe I should have used the eco mode a little bit more often, because I averaged 21.5 miles per gallon on my test loop, and that's short of the EPA's estimate of 23 miles per gallon in combined driving. Now, my favorite of the 3 driving modes was normal, because I found the engine and transmission acceptably responsive in that mode, and I preferred the heft and feel of the steering. Now, 2 years ago, in 2015, Hyundai fixed the Santa Fe Sport's steering and suspension, resolving to a large degree complaints about the SUV's ride and handling. Today, it continues to provide secure, trustworthy driving dynamics. Better tires would certainly help it to take corners with more speed, but otherwise there's nothing to complain about. The problem is that aside from speedy acceleration and a transmission that always seems to be in the right gear at the right time, there isn't much to get excited about either. Aside, of course, from its fantastic warranty and roadside assistance coverage. In other words, the Santa Fe Sport goes fast, but it isn't much fun. While putting a set of stickier tires on this SUV might help in that regard, the problem is that the front seats already have a hard enough time holding the driver secure behind the wheel if you're taking S-curves with any amount of speed. Now, if you get out onto a straight road or a highway, the Santa Fe Sport 2.0T's leather-wrapped front seats are really comfortable. The front passenger seat also even has a power height adjuster, a recent trend in Hyundai products that I wholeheartedly applaud. Now, with leather, front seat heating is standard. The Ultimate package adds seat ventilation and a heated steering wheel, along with a panoramic glass sunroof, a premium sound system, navigation, and an impressive multi-view camera system. Now, I'm not a big fan of the Santa Fe Sport's dashboard design. It's busy, and the two-tone treatment is garish instead of upscale. Hyundai did replace the fake wood trim with a darker finish this year, though. Previously, it looked like a 20-year-old Lexus in here. Controls and instrumentation are, for the most part, thoughtfully laid out, and they're easy to use. Despite a somewhat small display screen, I find Hyundai's BlueLink infotainment system to be intuitive, and I love that the company provides actual volume and tuning knobs in addition to buttons with easy access to radio and map displays. Now, rear seat occupants are going to be comfortable in this SUV. It's real easy to get into and out of the Santa Fe, and my Ultimate model includes manual side window sunshades, a feature that parents of smaller children always appreciate, even with the dark tinted rear glass. Around back, my test vehicle has something called a smart tailgate, but sometimes it seems pretty dumb though. Here's how it works. It senses the proximity of the key fob. So if you're hanging around talking to other parents after the soccer game and you get too close to the back of your Santa Fe Sport, well, the tailgate might open when you don't intend it to, spilling your gear all over the parking lot. Don't worry, you can turn that feature off if you want to, and then you can turn it back on if you know you're going to be coming back out and you're going to have your hands full. Now, cargo space is a little tight for a vehicle pitched as a midsize SUV. It measures 35.4 cubic feet behind the rear seat and 71.5 cubic feet if you fold the rear seat down. Those numbers are in the same ballpark with several compact crossovers. Hyundai does provide handy storage bins beneath the cargo floor, though, and levers to fold the rear seats right from the cargo area. Now, because crossover SUVs are often purchased to serve family duty, rest assured that the Santa Fe Sport is a safe vehicle. First, it's offered with several driver assistance and collision avoidance technologies, including important ones like forward collision warning, automatic emergency braking, blind spot warning, and rear cross-traffic alert. Second, Blue Link provides access to features like SOS emergency assistance, automatic collision notification, and safe teen driver features like speed and curfew alerts. All are free for a trial period, and then after that, you've got to pay for a subscription. Third, the Santa Fe Sport gets top-notch 5-star crash test ratings from the federal government and a top Safety Pick Plus rating from the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety. Would I put my own kids in this SUV? Absolutely. Earlier in this review, I posed a question. Do you actually want a Hyundai Santa Fe Sport? Here's my professional, unbiased, expert answer. If you like the way it looks and you find it to be comfortable and it offers enough passenger and cargo space and you don't need more than 7.3 inches of ground clearance, then yes, you might want a Santa Fe Sport. You see, the Santa Fe Sport is hard to criticize because it doesn't make promises it can't keep. Certainly, practical reasons to buy this crossover outweigh emotional reasons, but there really isn't anything wrong with this SUV. And that means making a decision about buying one is purely dependent upon your own personal preferences. If it matters to you, I give it my stamp of approval. Be sure to check out my full review of the Santa Fe Sport on CarGurus.com, and if you found this review helpful, please share this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. For all of us at CarGurus, thank you for watching.